What's up, guys? This is Chris from DraftDashboard.com. Here are my DFS picks for NBA playoffs, Wednesday, June 2nd. These picks apply for DraftKings and FanDuel. Before I get started, please drop a like on this video and hit that red subscribe button and hit that bell icon so you don't miss our new videos. In this video, I'm gonna go over my top picks for today's NBA slate. And if you stick around to the very end of this video, we'll use the Draft Dashboard tools to make a DFS lineup using the picks we just made. Okay guys, we have a 4-game slate tonight. So let's take a look at the point guard position. I like Luka Doncic from the Dallas Mavericks playing the LA Clippers, who have a good defense overall. They've been middle of the pack defending opposing point guards. Luka Doncic has averaged 50.5 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 34 minutes per game with a 36% usage rate. He scored 34, 66, and 57 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 35, 38, and 38 minutes. He's projected at 55 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5.1 times value. He's 10,700 FanDuel salary, and he's 100 more on DraftKings. Vegas thinks there's going to be 217 points scored in this game, so I like Luka Doncic here versus the LA Clippers. Okay, another point guard that I like is Ja Morant from the Memphis Grizzlies playing the Utah Jazz, who have a good defense overall. They've been good versus opposing point guards, but Ja Morant has averaged 35.1 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 33 minutes per game with a 27% usage rate. But take a look at his last three games. He scored 48, 38, and 58 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 43, 39, and 43 minutes. So he's playing monster minutes. He's projected at 42 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5.1 times value. He's 8,200 FanDuel salary, and he's 400 more on DraftKings. Vegas thinks there's going to be 225.5 points scored in this game, so I like Ja Morant here versus the Utah Jazz. Okay, now if you're looking for a value play at the point guard position, take a look at Reggie Jackson from the LA Clippers playing the Dallas Mavericks, who have a good defense overall. They've been good versus opposing point guards, and Reggie Jackson has averaged 19.8 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 23 minutes per game with a 20% usage rate. But take a look at his last three games. He scored 24, 24, and 26 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 30, 33, and 30 minutes. So his minutes are way up there, and he's projected at 25 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5 times value. He's 5,000 FanDuel salary, and he's 300 less on DraftKings. So I like Reggie Jackson here versus the Dallas Mavericks. Okay, let's take a look at the shooting guard position. I like Donovan Mitchell from the Utah Jazz playing the Memphis Grizzlies, who have the 13th worst defense overall, and they give up the 5th most fantasy points to opposing shooting guards. Donovan Mitchell has averaged 40.6 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 33 minutes per game with a 34% usage rate. He scored 49, 40, and 28 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 34, 29, and 25 minutes. And his usage rate the last couple of games was 41 and 45%. So that's way up there. He's projected at 42 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5.1 times value. He's 8,300 FanDuel salary, and he's 100 less on DraftKings. We know Vegas thinks there's going to be 225.5 points scored in this game, so I like Donovan Mitchell here versus the Memphis Grizzlies. before I continue with the picks, I'm excited today because we added a new contest for everyone watching. If you want to enter the drawing for $100 PayPal, all you need to do is like this video, hit that subscribe button, and make a quick comment below to be entered into the drawing. We'll reply to a random comment and let you know that you won, and then we'll send you $100 PayPal. So it's that easy, and we pick a new winner every Saturday and announce them in our video. So get your comment in now so I can add another entry for you. Now guys, just as a quick note, we just released a free DFS contest on Draft Dashboard for MLB and NBA for DraftKings and FanDuel. There's over $500 available in the prize pool, and this is a totally free contest you can enter as a Draft Dashboard member. So make sure to click the link in the description of this video, give Draft Dashboard a try, and you can start playing in our free DFS contest and compete to win some money. Another shooting guard that I like is Paul George from the LA Clippers playing the Dallas Mavericks, who have a good defense overall. They've been good versus opposing shooting guards, and Paul George has averaged 40.5 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 34 minutes per game with a 30% usage rate. He scored 32, 45, and 52 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 35, 41, and 40 minutes. He's projected at 43.7 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5x value. He's 8,800 FanDuel salary and the same price on DraftKings. So I like Paul George here versus the Dallas Mavericks. Okay, let's take a look at the small forward position. I also like Kawhi Leonard from the LA Clippers playing the Dallas Mavericks. Kawhi Leonard has averaged 44.3 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 34 minutes per game with a 29% usage rate. Kawhi Leonard has been the most consistent fantasy player throughout the playoffs. He scored 55, 56, and 58 fantasy points in the last three games. And he even scored 58 fantasy points the game before that. So 55 fantasy points or more for four games in a row. And I'm just jumping around here, but look at his last five versus Dallas. 55, 56, 58, 58, 43. He's just got monster numbers going on here. So he played 35, 42, and 40 minutes in the last three games. He's been on fire. He's projected at 55 fantasy points here tonight, and that's 5.3x value. He's 10,300 FanDuel salary, and he's still 700 less on DraftKings. So he's a lock for me on DraftKings. I don't know how you don't play him, considering he's averaging 55 fantasy points or more. That's got to be close to 6x value over there on DraftKings. So I like Kawhi Leonard here versus the Dallas Mavericks. Okay, another small forward that I like. I'm going to give you a value play here. High risk, high reward, but I like DeAndre Hunter from the Atlanta Hawks playing the New York Knicks. And DeAndre Hunter has averaged 26.4 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 29 minutes per game with a 20% usage rate. He scored 8, 22, and 24 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 27, 35, and 31 minutes. He's projected at 24 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5.2x value. He's 4,600 FanDuel salary and the same price on DraftKings. Vegas thinks there's going to be 208 points scored in this game. So I like DeAndre Hunter here versus the New York Knicks. Okay, another value play or a mid-range play that I like is Rui Hachimura from the Washington Wizards playing the Philadelphia 76ers, who have a good defense overall. They've been good versus opposing small forwards. And Rui Hachimura, he's averaged 24.1 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 32 minutes per game with an 18% usage rate. He scored 44, 18, and 18 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 41, 27, and 25 minutes. So he's projected at 26 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5 times value. He's 5,200 FanDuel salary, and he's 400 less on DraftKings. So I like this pick because Vegas thinks there's going to be 230 points scored in this game. It's the highest scoring game on the slate, so it's worth getting some exposure to this game. So I like Rui Hachimura here versus the Philadelphia 76ers. Okay, who do we have at the power forward position? This looks to be one of the best plays on the slate, considering salary. So I like Daniel Gafford from the Washington Wizards playing the Philadelphia 76ers, who have a good defense overall. They've been good versus opposing power forwards, but Daniel Gafford has scored 35, 29, and 25 fantasy points in the last 3 games, playing 25, 22, and 20 minutes. So it looks like he's been earning himself some extra minutes. In each of the last 3 games, his minutes have been going up. So now he's projected at 28 fantasy points here tonight, and that's 5.5 times value. He's 5,100 FanDuel salary, and he's 400 less on DraftKings. So I like that price on both sites. That looks like a really good DraftKings price. We know Vegas thinks there's going to be 230 points scored in this game, so I like Daniel Gafford here versus the Philadelphia 76ers.
Real quick, guys, I got great news. For a limited time, we're offering a full 30-day trial to Draft Dashboard. You can try all of our DFS tools for all sports. You can try the Position Optimizer, where you can see the top players ranked for each position. And we added a new Player Trends tool, where you can see the top salary differences between FanDuel and DraftKings. It's a really good tool to help you pick out value for the site that you're playing on. Oh, and if you're tired of doing research every day, we just added a cheat sheet that shows hand-picked plays for the slate. No confusing stat lines, no headaches, just a simple cheat sheet that shows the absolute best players for your lineups.
Now, if you want to roll a dice with this pick, he's got potential here. I like Kristaps Porzingis from the Dallas Mavericks playing the LA Clippers, who have a good defense overall. They've been good versus opposing power forwards, but Kristaps Porzingis has averaged 37.4 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 31 minutes per game with a 27% usage rate. He scored 27, 21, and 40 fantasy points in the last 3 games, playing 27, 33, and 32 minutes. Now, it looks like his production is down a little bit because his usage rate is down a little bit, averaging a 27% usage rate on the season, but he's only had a 23, 17, and 19% usage rate in the last 3 games. So I think that's playing a role, or I think that has a factor on his low scoring here. And he's projected at 34 fantasy points here tonight, which he's totally capable of. He can put up 40 plus fantasy points here and crush value. But 34 fantasy points would be 5.2 times value. He's 6,600 FanDuel salary and 600 more on DraftKings. So if I'm going to play Kristaps Porzingis tonight, probably going to be on FanDuel. I'm not so interested in that DraftKings price. So I like Kristaps Porzingis on FanDuel here versus the LA Clippers. Okay, now I'm going to give you a value play. I like Marcus Morris from the LA Clippers playing the Dallas Mavericks. Marcus Morris has averaged 21.5 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 26 minutes per game with a 20% usage rate. He scored 22, 20, and 9 fantasy points in the last 3 games, playing 29, 33, and 24 minutes. He's projected at 22.7 fantasy points here tonight. That's 5.2 times value. He's 4,400 FanDuel salary, and he's 200 more on DraftKings. So I like Marcus Morris here versus the Dallas Mavericks. Okay, moving on to the center position. Okay, guys, so Joel Embiid, he's going to be out tonight.
So that opens up more playing time for Dwight Howard from the Philadelphia 76ers playing the Washington Wizards, who have the fourth worst defense overall, and they give up the second most fantasy points to opposing centers. Dwight Howard, he's averaged 20.8 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 17 minutes per game with an 18% usage rate. He scored 8, 20, and 21 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 13, 16, and 15 minutes. But I'm expecting him to get 20 minutes or more here, and that would put him at a projection of around 27 fantasy points, and that's 5.4 times value. He's 5,000 FanDuel salary, and he's 700 less on DraftKings. So I love that DraftKings price. And we know Vegas thinks there's going to be 230 points scored in this game, so it's a fantastic matchup, a high-scoring game, and a low-salary player who's got a good point-per-minute value. He's a 1.22 fantasy points-per-minute player, so if he can get 20 or 25 minutes, he's looking to crush value here on both sites, but especially on DraftKings. So I like Dwight Howard here versus the Washington Wizards. Okay, now if you're looking for a stud at the center position, I would go with Rudy Gobert from the Utah Jazz playing the Memphis Grizzlies, who have the 13th worst defense overall, and they give up the 13th most fantasy points to opposing centers. Rudy Gobert has averaged 40.5 fantasy points per game on the season, playing an average of 31 minutes per game with a 17% usage rate. He scored 34, 42, and 52 fantasy points in the last three games, playing 32, 35, and 35 minutes. He's projected at 40.6 fantasy points here tonight. Now on FanDuel, that's only 4.8 times value because he's 8,500 FanDuel salary, but he's 500 less on DraftKings. And we know Vegas thinks there's going to be 225.5 points scored in this game, and he's got a good matchup. So I like Rudy Gobert here versus the Memphis Grizzlies.
If you want to try all these daily fantasy tools for yourself, click the link in the description below this video or just go to draftdashboard.com. You can use our DFS lineup optimizer to build quality lineups using our picks and your own custom player pool. Click the link in the description below this video and try all these daily fantasy tools right now. Thanks so much for watching. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that bell icon so you can get instant updates whenever we post a new video.
Thank you so much for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, please smiggity smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Oh, and please comment below with your favorite player for this NBA slate. I love to hear what you guys have to think. Thanks again, and good luck.